G'day, welcome back to Buildsome. In this video, what I want to show you is how we calculate the number of steps and how wide they are to get up to a platform like this one. So this platform is 1600 mil high, or 1.6 meters. So the first formula you need is we take the rise of the flight, which is our 1600. We divide that by the average allowable rise of a step. So if you look at the National Construction Code here in Australia, we have this table. It tells us that for a rise or a riser, the maximum rise is 190 and the minimum rise is 115. So you can add those together, divide by 2, and you'll get 152, I think, off the top of my head. But we'll work with 150 mil. So our average rise is 150 mil. So if we divide our 1600 by 150, we get 10.6666. Now if I plot that out on here, you'll see that if each one of these is 150 mil, we actually end up with an uneven step at the top. Okay, so the distance from here to here is obviously not the same as the distance from here to here or here to here. So again, according to the National Construction Code, we can't have an uneven step in our flight, so that's not going to work. So what we do, and of course we know we're close, we can either round this up or down, doesn't really matter, but for reasons of efficiency, the less timber we have in the stairs, the more economical, so we'll say we're going to have 10, around that down to 10. So 10 rises in our flight. So if we now divide our 1600 by 10, we get 160. So 10 rises of 160 mil each. So 10 here. So all even. So that's going to work with the code. So that's how we work out our rises. So now we need to work out our goings. So we've got 10 rises. We've got to have 9 goings, always one less. Okay. So we take our 9 goings and we times that by the average going for a step. So if we go back to our table, we see over here on our going side, we have a maximum going of 355, a minimum going of 240, and the average again of that roughly, I think it works out about 297. So we'll just say 300 is our average going. So come back here, 9 goings. Average of 300, so it gives us a going of our flight of 2700. So that's the distance from the front of the first step to the front of the landing, or the back of the last step. That's a going of, that becomes our going of our flight. Now we need to make sure it works, and it should work in this case, but it's good to get used to it. So our easy going check is 2 rises plus a going, and they have to fall within our slope relationship, so they need to land somewhere between 700 and 550. So 160 plus 160 plus 300 gives us 620. So obviously that becomes between those two figures. So that should mean that this will be a comfortable set of stairs to walk up, and they comply with the National Construction Code. So there you go. That's how you work out the rises and goings for an unrestricted staircase.